He made us laugh hard every time you saw him on television, movies, nightclubs, arenas, hospitals, homeless shelters for our troops overseas, and even in a dying girl's living room for her last wish. He made us laugh big time. I spent many happy hours with Robert on stage. I mean, the brilliance was astounding. The relentless energy was kind of thrilling. I used to think if I could just put a saddle on him and stay on for 8 seconds, I was going to do okay. Robin, Whoopi, and I once were in Shea Stadium in the broadcast booth with the great Tim McCarver. It was Comic Relief Day for the New York Mets, and Robin knew nothing about baseball. I asked him, "What's your favorite team?" And he said, "The San Franciscos." So he was a little lost in the conversation, so I got an idea, and I said, "You know, Tim, we have a great Russian baseball player with us." And I looked over, his eyes got all bright, his ears perked up. It looked like he was a little dog that was inside all day, and the master came and said, "Hey, you want to go for a walk?" So I said, "What's baseball like in Russia?" Without missing a beat, he said, "Well, we only have one team, the Reds." Well, the next pitch, the batter fouled one off. It came screaming back at us. We ducked down. It slammed against the wall. Robin turned around and bounced into his hands, and he stood up and screamed, "I love America. I'm going to defect." He could be funny anywhere. We were such close friends. He would come to all of our great family functions, weddings, bar mitzvahs, that kind of thing. And he would sit with my older immigrant relatives like he was one of the guys. And he would tell them about his journey from his little shtetl in Poland to America. One uncle of mine said, "I came to America after World War II and I hitchhiked." And Robin said, "I waited till there was a 747 and a kosher meal." Well, as genius as he was on stage, he was the greatest friend you could ever imagine. Supportive, protective, loving. It's very hard to talk about him in the past because he was so present in all of our lives. For almost 40 years, he was the brightest star in a comedy galaxy. But while some of the brightest of our celestial bodies are actually extinct now, their energy long since cooled, but miraculously, because they float in the heavens so far away from us now, their beautiful light will continue to shine on us forever. And the glow will be so bright, it'll warm your heart, it'll make your eyes glisten, and you'll think to yourselves, "Robin Williams, what a concept."
"And yet look, vile fool, come thee hither."
"No!
Thou hast forced me to wear designer jeans for no reason." "I will walk now, and cameraman shall be going, 'Where's he going now?'" "Where am I now?"
"Let me borrow your little shawl."
"We've never met before, have we?"
"I came to Bombay last year." "I would like to welcome you to Iran." "Help me."
"God gives, you know, it gives you a penis and a brain, and only enough blood to run one at a time."
"There are times my son looks at me, gives me that look in the eyes like, 'Well, what's it gonna be?'"
"I don't know. But maybe along the way, he'd take my hand, tell a few jokes, and have some fun. Come on, pal. You're not afraid, are you?"
"Nah."
The heart.